Well, they have the best record in the league. That's what I meant. Quarterback, a good running back, good no. All right, I'm ready. I'm going with the Jags. Yep.
What's my profile?
The profile.
Yeah, you made me a profile.
Yeah. I can if I want to. I can make you your own profile.
Who are you running with?
Seahawks. I'm going to get no. Yeah, I'll go with win. No. I won without win.
Hey, no, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Kylie, what color is my pants?
Blue.
Blue.
Blue. Where's gray?
Gray.
Are you dark?
Yeah. No, I'm this. I'm gray. Dark gray.
Gray.
Kylie, stop pressing stuff. Kylie, you want to sit in a seat?
I have a seat.
What time? Super Bowl?
Sleepers in the way it is. Yeah, Super Bowl. Let's go.
Cell clock off. Simulation competitive.
No, ma'am, don't get on the table. Jackson up here.
Come on.
Yeah,
come
go. On. Oh, dinosaur's on. Go. Go watch it.
Come on.
Daddy, puppy pals is on.
No, dinosaurs. Come on.
Go ahead, Daddy's. Daddy's
ooh,
playing.
Oh, Andre Reed. Andre Reed.
Let me see. Come on.
Ready to beat up my dad, guys. Let's go. Alright, Dad. Come on. Let's go beat you.
We have played 266 games in this NFL season. Only one
he's about to get crushed by his 11-year-old son. He always beats me. I beat him the last two times.
Super Bowl.
Dad,
tonight
come on!
It's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy.
And fight for the Lombardi Trophy. This year is going to be in Indianapolis.
Tackle spot to snow him under for a loss of four. Great job, defense. defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football before he knew it, he was on his back.
So I just bring his way back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football.
All right. Seahawks ain't doing nothing on this drive. I'll take a field goal.
Okay. Even just being nice, the last two plays were not very good offensively. So if you're the play caller, was it the team's execution or was it strategy? If it was execution, you continue to call the game to where you're calling it. But the strategy, change up what you're doing and figure it out.
Best corner.
Third and long, it's Wilson. He's got Lockett.
That was the safety was covering up.
Tyler Lockett, 33 yards. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead.
Brandon, I read it.
The Super Bowl. A touchdown scored in any game is big. And this one is massive.
Blair Walsh had to attempt the extra point. And this will give the Seahawks a 7-0 lead.
I'm the Seahawks. There's no beating the Seahawks.
Here's Walsh now to kick this
one. Well, that's a terrible kick. Eh, it's better than your kicks.
Gotta be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14 yard line.
She's distracted.
They'll get eight on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Who cares?
That was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Oh, has him wide open. No. Sherman.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy who can run it and catch it, and we just saw him complete a big time play for a touchdown.
And we can break that
close game
down
again
down pretty easily. One play, long touchdown pass into the end zone. This is fielded at the top of the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're not positioned?
Get the feet in.
I dare say that the answer would be
I thought that was going to be picked, so I was scared. Oh, crap.
But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
The Aaron Rodgers play against the Cowboys for the game winner.
Now he'll throw deeper. It's inside the 20. And he's going to be out of bounds down the inside of the 20.
Kylie, get down.
Come on, get down. Go to the controls.
Game controls.
Passing.
Ball in the air. Aggressive catch, ball hawk, rocks, switch players. For the 48-yard pickup. So 18 yards. Let's take a look at that. Take a look at this corner here. He's running. My dad's not there. That would have been a pick, but no. Alright, so this was a play that I actually screwed up a cam. Chancellor. He would have had a good, nice tackle, but I thought Sherman could have got him after I actually. Look what I did. I pressed square on accident, and that kind of happened, so I went on Sherman and tried to get the tackle, but he took a bad angle. Look, I snapped it. He throws it for a chance. Is it going to be caught? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. He got it. Hey, come on. Huh? Oh, that's nice. Uh, for 2 yards. Come on, Dad. Take a look at this. Player stats. 7 for 7, 7. Signed everything. 85 yards already. Completion percentage 70. 1 TD pass thrown already. 1-0 interception. Rushing. Thomas Rawls. 20. Russell Wilson, 28. Him, 4, 32. He's 79. Jimmy Graham, 65 yards. Tyler Lockett, 56. No, 64, 56. Then we have Doug Baldwin, 48. This guy with 17. And then this guy with 55. All right, let's go, Dad. Come on, Dad. Falcons have this guy in the hands. Playing a 4-3 offense. I do not know what a 4-3 offense is, or defense. I meant 4-3 defense. That means I have 3 linebackers, 4 safety, 2 safeties and 2 corners, and then I have 4 defensive line.
Harrison going to give to Rawls. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down at the 16. It's a loss of two, now third down.
Now, this is playoff football. I mean, what a big-time tackle. Perfectly executed with a little extra emphasis there.
And got him for a loss as well. On third down, Wilson. And he's going to go down. He sacked back at the 24.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Well, he got an early chance to redeem himself, and he's able to put that one through.
And he'll be happy he got a second chance so quickly after missing the first one. Now he's got the confidence back up before we even finish the first quarter.
That's fielded in the end zone. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Heading back onto the field, here's a look at Devontae Freeman now. Responsible for well over 100 yards of total offense, but still hasn't found the end zone. Do you think that's in the back of his mind going into this drive?
It's always in the back of the mind of a player having that type of a day because you want that gratification for your work, right? You want that stamp on top of everything. But bottom line for him, he's doing great work. Sometimes it just opens it up for other people to actually get into the end zone for him.
The runners, you know, would they rather have 60 yards, three touchdowns, or 150 no touchdowns?
I think more than likely 150 and no touchdowns. But all the runners that I know would say, I'll take 150 and three touchdowns. They're greedy that way.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
On third down, Ryan. That's complete, Hooper. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. A Falcon first down, Ryan to his young tight end, Hooper.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work, and that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring us to the end of the first quarter. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two. They've got it second and 4 to start things out. Freeman again. And some room to maneuver. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. That good for 22 and a first down.
Boy, where would these guys be? His performance. Performance on the ground. That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, got to like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Now they'll throw it with Ryan. Getting it out left side to Sanu. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Ryan to Sanu. Good for an Atlanta first down. Now Ryan going to give it to Freeman. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
And there's a nice stop for the defense. They've had a tough time containing this guy all game long, but maybe they can build a little bit off of that play, a little bit of confidence, a little bit of momentum. Yeah, every now and then you can actually tackle that guy.
On second down, Ryan. And that is incomplete here.
The effort's always going to be there. Everyone's always going to try and make a catch. But underthrown balls, I think, are the toughest ones to come back and get because usually your momentum's going in the opposite direction when you're trying to stop, break, and come back and get it.
Third down, Ryan. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
The drive begins with a run by Rawls. He's got room to run past the 20. And all the way to the opposite 49-yard line. A big run that time by Rawls. 44 yards on the ground. The ultimate speedster showing that speed at this, in front of his home crowd. They love that.
Made me stand up on that run because right now all I want to do is wave to the crowd. More noise, more noise. You got to reward him for that one. A big-time monster run.
Back to the ground on first. Again, it's Rawls. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and 4 and second and 8 and 9.
On second down, Wilson, and a hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Now it's Wilson. And he finds Jimmy Graham. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. A Seahawk first down. Wilson to his big target, Graham.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Grady Jarrett able to get in there and drop him behind the line.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
And a short gain down to about the 33. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to third down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Throwing is Wilson. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Brooks Reed in there to get him for a loss of 9. And that'll lead to fourth down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good, but there is a flag down. He might get another shot at this. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And they stretch the lead to six. It's 20-14 now. So it goes down as an eight-play drive, and they cap it with the field goal.
Yeah, they were able to pick up a few first downs along the way, but they couldn't keep the momentum going all the way into the end zone.
On the return, here's Justin Hardy. Onto the field now comes Devontae Freeman. And Charles, you can't really fault him. He's over 100 yards already. He's not the reason they're losing.
And that is really unusual because ordinarily, when you've set the tone this way and have run it this effectively, usually your team's in control. So it's a very strange situation. And you're right, you can't fault him. He's done a great job for his team thus far.
I'm guessing he's saying, feed me on the sidelines. Now will they continue to do it?
Oftentimes when a guy has a game like this, he's going to take his offensive line out to dinner afterwards. But after a play like that, he may tell them, instead of getting the steaks, guys, we might have to go for the hot dogs.
On second down, here's Ryan. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Give him three on the play, and it'll be third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
On third down, Ryan. Escape the pressure. Ryan goes down. Michael Bennett able to get him down for a loss of 11 on the play. And it'll be fourth down. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DM.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
35 yards that time on the punt. And the Seahawks will have great field position to start this drive. They take over on the short side of the field. And time for us to spotlight Doug Baldwin. He's doing what he's capable of, having a solid game. Not the most amazing game. He's not over 100 yards, but a good game so far.
And you just know that mentally, he feels like he's one catch away from turning it into a great game and starting on that road. And the defenders are well aware of that, too. They've got to figure out a way to not let that escalate. Keep him right in this zone here and call it a day, because otherwise, he can really decimate them.
Better believe they are well aware of his playmaking ability. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. We'll come back on Super Bowl Sunday after this. A reminder, coming up at the intermission, we'll get highlights of this Super Bowl from Larry Ridley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Wilson, buying time to his left. He lets it fly for Lockett. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. They give him a gain of 38.
Sometimes it's design, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he was able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
They go play action here on first down. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Graham. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of 5.
think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Now Wilson on second down. Dan feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. Deion Jones leading the surge there. He drops in for a loss of 6.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
On third and goal, Wilson under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sack back around the 8. Adrian Claiborne in there to drop him, and back-to-back sacks now bring up 4th and long.
And it appears to...
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. Oh, this is a complete mishit. It's no good. Didn't even get it there. And the deficit will stay at 2 field goals. So not only does the fumble recovery not turn into 6, it doesn't even turn into 3.
And they let him off the hook right there. You have to be able to capitalize on sudden change situations. So to go 3 plays and then miss a field goal? That's a huge disappointment.
And he's going to take this up past the 10 to about the 11. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. The Falcons on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. The former Indiana Hoosier here, Tevin Coleman. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on 4th down. So we've reached intermission in what has been a back-and-forth Super Bowl. I know when I joke about you guys skipping halftime, sometimes you get frustrated, but this is the Super Bowl. You got to watch the halftime show of the Super Bowl. All right, let's get you to the 3rd quarter. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And here now come the Falcons. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works.
And that's one of the few times they've been able to contain him. He's had a heck of a game, and maybe he's getting a little bit tired from how many times he's carried the ball. But I always think back to what all those old coaches said. The ball's not that heavy. Keep carrying it, kid.
And his throw here is incomplete. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target. And that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
Flush to his right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Mike Bennett in there to pick up his 2nd sack now of the afternoon. Here we go on 4th down with Ryan. Hits his target. It's Taylor Gabriel. And he's got the 1st down as he's up to the 45-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold them to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Back to the ground, this time with Freeman. And he works his way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
From midfield now, here's Ryan. And the third down pass falls incomplete. It's been this way most of the afternoon, hasn't it? This secondary really put this receiving core on lockdown.
Listen, they've worked together like a basketball team is playing excellent defense. Great communication, doesn't matter whether it's man or zone. And especially against deep balls, as we saw there, they're not giving up anything to them.
Interesting call there to go for it. And this defense will take over right at midfield. From midfield now, here's Wilson. Forced out to his left. And he will avoid the contact as he slides to a stop. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Adrian Claiborne. There to get him his second sack now of the afternoon.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
On second down, here's Wilson. He's going to air this out for Baldwin. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. Now we've got whistles and movement up front. I think this is against Seattle.
False start, offense.
Yeah, that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves them back 5. The Seahawks on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This will be third and forever. From the gun, it's Wilson. And this is going to be incomplete.
There are a good number of coaches that anytime they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
Here's John Ryan now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. Hoping for there as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. So out come the Falcons now. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, That allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good. But when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Freeman again, a first down carry. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Freeman with a fast feed, and they do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the 2. 38 yards on the scamper there. They'll look to run with Freeman. And he gets in. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman with his third touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Falcons are an extra point away from moving out in front.
Well, 3 scores in this game, I think that deserves some type of a broad gesture. I know in hockey, that's called a hat trick and people throw their hats out on the ice. What about us? What can we do for this guy?
Well, if I'm his teammates, I'm buying him a little steak dinner tonight, right? At least a skirt steak, probably a filet.
Oh, you're going big. I like that.
Yeah, I mean, skirt at minimum, skirt filet at maximum.
On. You can't give the guy a skirt steak.
That's true. Filet. 10 ounce. 16 ounce.
Porterhouse.
Fine. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a 2-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
And out now come the Seahawks. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And he'll be out of bounds up near midfield at the 49. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Obviously, a big play was needed. And you can see his eyes light up as he realized there's absolutely no one in front of him. And he takes off and goes, and goes a long way. Not only does he pick up a first down, but a big gain to boot.
Now it's Wilson. Baldwin with it over the middle. Doug Baldwin. And all the way in. Touchdown, Seattle. Doug Baldwin. And the Seahawks are going to take the lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts. All right, because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Pretty clean and simple there. Just 2 plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number 2. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. Andre Roberts now to return it. And some good coverage there by the kick team as they'll bring him down at the 16-yard line. Heading back onto the field, here's a look at Devontae Freeman now. He is north of 200 yards. Any time that you can say you're north of 200 yards, you've done something right.
Yeah, you're going to get some big check marks on your grade sheet, and you're going to be in heavy rotation on all the highlight shows, and you might even make a magazine cover or two.
He's hoping for more, the cherry on top maybe, as this game goes forward. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Play was stopped on that play, but he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
Now Freeman, he's been busy today. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6. Ryan. Escaping the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. 8 yards that time. Able to take off, and the result is a first down.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
Ryan on the handoff. It's Freeman. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. It's a give to Freeman running right. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11. Running right, this is Freeman. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
Throw on third down, Ryan. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. They'll run it with Coleman. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down to the 46. Call it a 3-yard gain, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches.
Yeah, on fourth and inches, you've got to be quick with your decision-making when you're running the football. You've got to find the hole and go. And he does a nice job here picking up the first down with a few yards to spare.
A 20th carry now for Freeman. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Falcons. They'll have the football, but trailing on the scoreboard as we get set to begin the fourth. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by the All-Pro free safety, Earl Thomas. And some room to work.
That's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. It'll be a pickup of 5 on the keeper. It's second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here.
Encroachment, defense.
So 5 yards there as one of the big guys up front moved.
And in a 4-3 front, you got the two defensive tackles right near the football. I know there's a lot of movement around there, but they're always taught to have one eye on the football. Apparently, that didn't happen.
Here's Wilson throwing the out route and complete. That's Baldwin. First down, Seahawks. Wilson to Baldwin. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
Wilson again to Rawls. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. So the solid run on first, and I would imagine no real hurry to run that second down play.
No, it's all in your quarterback now. He's going to keep an eye on the play clock and bleed things down, and he's not going
to. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Thomas Rawls, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. And the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
A drive there of just 4 plays. And it's Thomas Rawls who finishes it off with a touchdown run. And a good job here by the Falcons, their hands team, able to recover it. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
On second down, Freeman, and this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1. On 3rd and 1, Ryan. Flushed out, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Jaron Reed coming in to drop it for a loss of 8, and it'll be 4th down. And Charles, they only needed a yard there. They try to pass the football. What do you think?
Well, I can't really go all out and kill them for the call, because that 3rd and 1 fake and throw it over the top for a big play, that often does work, but in this situation, the pressure got to him.
Here we go. It's Ryan on 4th down. Finding Gabriel complete. And he's able to pick up the 1st down here before he goes down at the 26. 17 yards on the pickup. And they're able to move the chains as they convert on 4th and long. Shift together here from the D-line. fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. Wide open receiver complete. And he is going to feel that one. Knocked down hard. 23 yards on the play. From the shotgun, Ryan. Being chased out. Touchdown, Falcons. Bryant now to tack on the extra point. And that'll cut the lead down now to a touchdown. So the drive there took six plays, and it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. Sure to kick it away. Very cool. A miscommunication on the lateral. The ball's out. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
When you kick off and you go downfield and get the ball back, that's what I call a great opportunity.
In a one-score game, I always circle, and you know this, but in my play-by-play sheet, I circle big plays that could be turning points. This could be a turning point.
Did you put a second circle around this? Or this
I put a star. I put a star. And a great spot to start this drive from here. Now Ryan on first down. It's caught over the middle, Hooper. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. Second down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. And a nice gain of 21 yards. First down, Ryan. His pass caught at the 4. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They'll run it now out of the gun. They give them 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal. From the gun, it's Ryan. Steps away to his... And he will score! Touchdown, Falcons! Matt Ryan with his third touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game.
That was not a designed run. It was supposed to be a pass, but it turned into an exceptional run. What a scramble for a touchdown.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. Short, and a mistake on the lateral. It's a loose ball, and the Falcons grab it, and they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line. And that one is his second fumble loss. Not a good look out of your return man.
And not only does he hurt the momentum for his team or even change momentum of the game, but now they've got a decision to make on his own sideline. Does he continue to do that? Do you keep him in that role, or do you bring someone else in at this time?
Go, go, go. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. 4 yards on the pickup, and it'll make it a second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Tie game late, and the offense really has to be conscious of the clock here as it's becoming a factor late in this ballgame. They'll run it now out of the gun. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other bats in the league.
On first and 10, it's Ryan. He goes underneath to Freeman. And he is out of bounds, but not before taking this down to the 8. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Time for a break. We're back to perhaps crown a champion after this. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Again, it'll be Freeman. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It's a loss of 4. Now third down. We've had some wild Super Bowl finishes recently. 49 in Arizona, 51 in Houston. Now this one. This offense so far on third down, not so hot. 2 for 9 to this point. This is third and goal. Here's Coleman. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. And 3 yards on the carry there as his defense holds strong and takes it to fourth and goal. Have to kick this field goal, don't you?
No question about it. Look at the clock. Look at the situation. Kick the field goal. Thank you.
42-year-old veteran's kick is up and good. And the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. All right, so time to reset here. It's a huge kick there, gives them the lead, but they've got to be careful that their celebrations aren't a little too premature.
You're exactly right about that, because there still is time for the other guys to run a few plays and get into field goal position. So this defense is going to need to come up with one final stop if they're going to get out of here with a victory.
Doug Baldwin and company getting ready to go again on offense. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 36 seconds to go in half number two. He's back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no. It was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here. The Seahawks on third down. They've converted three times and eight chances. This is third and 16. They'll look to throw. And he finds Jimmy Graham. They give him 27 yards on the third down conversion. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
He'll look to throw. Going to Rawls on the dump off. And he gets it down to the 32. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Richardson. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. Now, he's been quiet all afternoon. He may have just come up with a play of the day right there, though.
Obviously, it's not the volume in what you get done. It's the quality, and that was a quality catch right there.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. Is right there. It's good. And they will tie this game here in the final seconds. So a money kick there in the final seconds. And now, barring any hijinks on the kickoff here, partner, I think you and I, we're going to settle in for a little overtime.
And I wouldn't have it any other way. This has been a dogfight all through regulation. No reason to think it won't continue in the extra period.
And an overtime playoff game, but the rules, they stay the same as they did in the regular season.
That's exactly right. Whoever scores first, unless it's a touchdown, the other team has a chance to match. That's how it really gets played out. But remember this, no matter how far we go in overtime, in the regular season, there was only one period. Here, we're going to go until we have a winner.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20. And now back out comes the offense. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime,
That gets double, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves them with a 2nd and 3. They run from the pistol here with Freeman. And he'll get about 3 here as he's out to the 30. Here comes a big one now in overtime. This is 3rd and inches. A handoff, Devontae Freeman. And again, worth pointing out, we are in uncharted waters here. A Super Bowl game never gone to overtime, but here we are with a title on the line.
And one thing I know that we share, we come at things from an optimistic view. So I certainly hope that this game gets decided by someone being a hero, making a big play, as opposed to someone being a goat and really making the wrong one.
Absolutely. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. Freeman a tailback. He's got him running left. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
First throw in overtime now for Ryan. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up 3rd down. So 3rd down coming up. And Charles, I guess the question for me, where does 4 down territory begin possibly?
I guess for me it begins if you have 4th and 5 or less. Because you've got to understand your team and know what your play calls are. What do you have that you think you're confident that you can pick up that type of yardage? It might be 4th and 3 for some teams, but I think anything under 4th and 5, they'll think about going for it.
Here's Ryan. Oh, and it's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowl quarterback, Richard Sherman. A costly mistake here in OT.
And you know what they say when you throw an interception like that in overtime? You don't usually get a chance to throw a 2nd one. I mean, I'm not sure of the analytics on it. Let's ask Marvin, our statistician, to ring that down for us. That's typically how coaches and teams feel about it. You throw one, you likely cost yourself the game.
It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll be left with just 1 remaining here at OT. Now what can Wilson do here in the OT? Oh, and it's intercepted. And now a fumble. The ball's out, and the Falcons grab it. Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. Neither team scored yet. Now we go to sudden death. Next points win this game.
How about the tension right now? It is ratcheted up, isn't it? I mean, now whatever happens, points are scored. That's your ball game. Can't wait to see the defense now. Do they get a little more aggressive in order to not let the team just drive the ball easily down the field?
Got to be careful though, right?
Yeah, if you're too aggressive and just give up something easy and cheap. But some defensive coordinators, they'd rather take a stand that way as opposed to being nickel and dime down the field.
Again, it'll be Freeman. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He lost 4 there, and it's 3rd down. He's had some big runs in this game. Not there, though.
But I don't think they're going to be deterred by that play right there. He's had some nice runs in the game. And how many times have we seen a good running back get stopped, yet turn it into something big on a later carry? I'd stay with him.
down and goal from the eight. Coleman. He couldn't quite find the goal line, but a good run of 8 yards is going to make it an interesting fourth and goal now. It's Coleman here. Oh, and I think he went backward. He did. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Seahawks able to come up with a goal line stand. So the defensive front holding strong there on fourth and inches.
And how about the battle of big people up front? That turned into a leverage game, didn't it? Defensive linemen, they want it lower than the offensive guy.
Oh, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And it's over. The Lombardi Trophy belongs to the Falcons. Yes, the Atlanta Falcons are the Super Bowl champions. And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever.
Twice already.
So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done.
Aaron Rodgers. He's injured. He can't play with him.
The collective happiness makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them.
How is his foot when I went down? All right. I gave you a chance. That was even. That was on YouTube. I was live streaming us playing the game.
Was you? Is that why you had that plugged in?
Uh huh.
Yeah, I know.
And now it's all over YouTube.
And they end this year just how everybody watched in the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth.
Something.
For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.
Woo! I lost, guys. My dad is the Super Bowl champion. Or something. Make me happy. Things that I used to do, love to do. That did not just happen though. Oh my god. I'm in a stream right now. I'm gonna go to view this in YouTube. Make you happy.